Welcome to Moviecaps. Today, I will show you an intellectual thriller from 2012, titled, Traveling Salesman. Spoilers ahead. Watch out, and take care. The movie is based on the premise that mathematician Kurt Gödel wrote a letter to John von Neumann in 1956, postulating the existence of a single proof that could unlock the fundamental laws that bind our universe. As the world is closer to discovering its true potential, it can raise serious implications of the equation P equals NP. Four top-class mathematicians, sitting in a conference room in a secret government facility, discuss the implications of the project they are working on. As the project is able to breach any encryption system, it creates a potential threat. One of the mathematicians, Dr. Tim Hortons, is concerned about the future applications of the equation, and thinks it was not included in their initial contract with the US government. While discussing the problem, one of them indicates it's a combined project, and they must agree on the solution, to make it more accurate and trustworthy. A cutback to a conference shows Dr. Tim Horton talking about the problem and its potential applications that can be used in multiple fields. Back in the conference room, John discusses his concerns that the implications of the project are not self-evident, and they won't be able to get further funding to continue working on it. Although the project is classified, Tim thinks the findings should be made public in their name, so anyone can benefit. Others disagree with him, because the large-scale implications might be a concern, and can also be misused, as they still lack the data about the possibilities. In this case, the findings can be a threat to many. Timothy remembers working at the office with his colleague, where he discussed the possibility of devising a system capable of finding an accurate solution in no time, because trying every possible outcome can take forever. In the conference room, John talks about the two points of view on the current situation. Some think they should leave it unsolved, and others consider it a huge discovery that can change the course of history. Although they are all well aware of the wide applications of the problem at hand, it comes with a lot of concerns, especially if the solutions are misused like nuclear weapons. In that case, it would be a chain reaction no one can control. They need to find a solution that can maximize the benefits, but with minimum negative outcomes. While discussing the project, one of them says, each one of them used their expertise to solve their part of the algorithm, but the professor disagrees with him, saying he had issues with validating his work. He further says, P equals NP is a more significant problem, and every idea of knowledge is based on it. The solution can pave the way for greater impacts, so they must focus on finding the correct answer. Timothy explains the problem with an example, saying there can be an unlimited number of possibilities and right answers, but they cannot spend time validating each one. So they need to find one key that can fit into all problems. In the conference, Timothy discusses the vague concept of future implications of mathematics. The government official arrives to discuss the future of the project and the conditions put up by the government to get them on board. He thanks them for their time and efforts and assures their requirements will be fulfilled. He asks if they have any questions to ask before signing the contracts, which ensures each one of them will get $10 million for their part of the algorithm. As a result, they have to hand over the findings to the US government. He tells them that although the project costs over $22 million, it's still worth it as there is unlimited potential. They also have to sign a non-disclosure agreement to not let anyone know about the results. He warns everyone, if there is any breach of information on their part, they will have to face serious consequences including legal implications. They ask if there are any chances of releasing the results to the general public at any time. He assures the results might be applied to some problems, but for now, they can't make it public, as it's a matter of national security. Horton once again argues with the official, as no such condition was discussed before signing the contracts, but he tries to convince him by saying it's in the country's interest to not let the details out. He further threatens that if they reveal anything, it will be a violation of the contract, and they can be arrested as a result. As they are close to the solution, their privileges will continue for 6 more months for now. After that, they won't be able to access the network they are using to communicate with each other. Professor reveals, with the solution of the problem, the access won't be a problem, as they can hack into anything. They tell him the solution will enable them to decode any encryption system in the world. While discussing further points with him, they tell the official, the initial contract did not include anything about the possible implications of the solution. He tells them their identifications will also remain anonymous, along with the results, as it's a national security concern. If they reveal their names and something terrible happens to them, the government won't take any responsibility. The project can be of great benefit for the country in the future, when the conflicts and wars won't be conventional as they are in the current situation. All the nations are working on becoming economic powers, or excelling in intelligence, but they can't let anyone breach the US security systems. Horton tells him, the new applications will enable them to break into any system in the world, resulting in trillions of dollars of information. He thinks every system uses a different algorithm, and they cannot hack into each one of them, but Horton disagrees with him, saying the fundamental is the same, and if they can solve one, they can solve others too, and that's what the equation P equals NP means. By using the new solution, they won't have to work on solving every problem individually, as it will be able to solve all problems at once. With this, they can hack into anything with the right software, and no one will be able to recognize or encounter them. For instance, they might be able to shut down the power systems of a country in case of an attack, but it will have consequences for them as well. With this improved system, they won't need to turn off the power, as it will be able to give access to any information they want to transmit. Horton thinks they must discuss each point of the agreement, as it's different from the original. The official admires his efforts in solving the problem no one else could, but they can't change the contract. It leads to another argument within the group, as Horton thinks the government is being inconsiderate by keeping it classified, because this way the results won't be of any use to the general public. He does not take Horton's concerns seriously, as it's not his individual project, and everyone has done their own part, but they don't have as many concerns as him. Horton thinks it's their moral responsibility to study every aspect, because the results can be misused and lead to massive destruction, just like what happened in the case of nuclear weapons. The government representative thinks, although the results can be negatively implied, it does not mean the government is planning to do it. Horton disagrees, by saying the same approach was used with the atomic bomb, but it wiped out thousands of people within a fraction of seconds. They don't seem to reach any conclusion, as neither of them is ready to compromise, or step back from his stance. Professor thinks, they should have been given some kind of initiative that can help them continue the work, but the official says, they should consider it a national duty to enhance the country's security system. He says they must continue to find out the solutions, as it has a multiple ranges of benefits, including security, restoration of peace, and a more prosperous future for present and future generations. With increasing threats from different countries like China, Russia, and North Korea, they must update the system to cope with changing situations. They are concerned, if the results are negatively used, the community will know they were the ones involved. If something terrible happens, they cannot use the excuse that they did it for science, without knowing the disastrous effects. The official says, they should be proud of working on a project that can change the course of history. Horton thinks they deserve the answers, about what's government's plan for the future applications. He does not give any answers, and announces to conclude the meeting, but Horton still wants this discussion to continue and forces him to resume. He again insists on making it public, but he assures the information is more valuable if it's classified. They cannot make him change anything in the agreement, or use the information on their own. If they do so, their privileges will be taken away, and they might have to face consequences as the result of the violation. One of the mathematicians signs the contract, by saying none of them can predict the future implications, and they must continue working on the project to let things unfold. He is backed by the others except for Tim Horton. He says none of them can fully understand the implications, as every coming generation will continue to improve the existing algorithms. As a result, the application will continue to multiply, and only time can answer their concerns. After finding out that they agreed to continue working on the project, Horton reveals he kept some details hidden. The revelation leads into another argument, as they think it's a collaborative project, and he cannot omit the information. The official assures, his objections are noted and will be dealt with, but Horton is not satisfied with him. He tells them, his system has the power to shut it all down. In that case, they will be left with nothing to work upon. He further reveals, the results are capable of decoding any encryption system in the world. As a result, the security can suffer great damage, because if someone uses the solution to its full sail, any security system can collapse in a few seconds. The official thinks he is suggesting a large-scale hacking, which is not possible, because every system has a different working mechanism. Horton asks for more time to work out the details that can maximize the implications. He says they have great respect for what they have done, but he cannot do anything for the group. Horton still does not sign the contract, to which he threatens that he might lose his career, money, as well as family, as they have every detail about his life. Horton eventually signs the contract by finding no other way out. In the end, he reads a letter from the White House, admiring his efforts toward the finding of the solution. He spots an Illuminati symbol on the letterhead, and it sparks something in his mind. He launches a supervirus that apparently breaches into every computer in the world, and shuts it down. The end. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you'd like to see more videos like this.